Okay, so now I have the 2013 Lincoln MKS. This is the one with the navigation and heated seats, and doesn't have the sunroof. It's missing the panoramic roof. It's probably about the only option it's missing. These are really sharp looking vehicles, always have been.
Can I stand by the door?
Yeah, sure, go ahead. Everybody likes a Lincoln. Obviously a lot of chrome accents on this. You get the alloy wheels, you get front and rear sensors. I think this also has the thing that parks itself, I believe. All right, so we have total MSRP of $58.75. Your base price is $44,805. Your total options are $53,000. That's what gets you to the MSRP of $50,000. Your packages are the equipment group 102A, which basically has blind spot monitoring, heated steering wheel, memory, foot pedals, power rear sunshade, rear view camera, navigation, the THX audio, and active park assist. Yeah, I thought it. So it does do the parking. So it's one of these little park itself. It's got the premium wood package. So it's pretty much loaded. Like I said, the only thing I think this thing's missing is the sunroof. All right, so here you are, 2013, 3.7 V6, 6-speed transmission, which pretty much everything's going to 6-speed now for gas mileage. All right, so your gas mileage is 18 and 26, overall 21. Gets a rating of 5 out of 10 for gas mileage, 5 out of 10 for smog rating. And even though all these ratings are good, it did not get ratings here yet. Apparently, again, the sticker was generated before they were published. Generally, you can go online and find those. They're usually there by the time someone's interested in actually buying the vehicle. You see a lot of chrome accents. All right, so I'm gonna pop the hood and do the trunk, and we'll the next part. What am I doing?
It's not an automatic hood. That's pretty cool.
Finally found something with hydraulic arms. they can put it in the Lincoln, they can put it in the Forge. Just so much nicer. Alright, so there's your battery, there's your fuse, there's your brake. A little dipstick, a little fill, windshield wash, transmission, not seeing power steering, and not noticing transmission. Yep, there's an overall view of it. What I like about this, I can pull it right down, very nice. So that makes it easier for me, but obviously for anyone, it really just makes it easier. More chrome accents. Okay, and then here's your trunk. For golf bags. Always seems a big thing on Lincolns. Get quite a bit of depth storage in there. You got a hole in the center. In case you gotta run something long through, like skis, you can run right through that hole. Mats back here, and then underneath there will be your tire storage. Emergency pull in case you get locked in the trunk. We do have a backup camera on this one, so hopefully I can remember to show you the backup camera and backup sensors. Obviously you need those in order to be able to do the park assist. The inside. Get your automatic control on the windows, lock on the door, there's your door handle, leather seats. And in the back here we have heat. We have 12 volt power. And then this is to control the AC flow. So these are heated rear seats. This is a piece in the center, drops down as an armrest, and then also allows you access into the trunk or something to come through from the trunk into here, like skis. This is convenient if you got something you just want to grab right back here. And this has a little storage pocket right in the armrest. Those two cup holders. Alright. View of the front from the back. Again, no sunroof. And we do have lights that you can turn off and on. That light is on because I have the door open, but if I close the door, the light should go off like it just did. And if I push this button, it comes on. Alright. You do have storage pockets in the rear. Okay, another quick outside view. And again, this is Irwin's in Laconia, New Hampshire. Now I'm gonna do the front, and then we'll go see what we find next. Okay, so again, power windows, power mirrors, power locks, manual lock, power seats. Brake is a push on, push off. That's how you raise your, oh, why is that not showing up? Angle was just wrong. There we go. Couldn't see the trunk. Okay, very comfy seats. I'm gonna turn the fan speed down now so I don't have to yell over it. No, that's temperature. Well, fan.
Now we have it down to a little bit lower. Okay. So now we got it down.
Alright, so now at least you can hear me in here. Alright, so here's your lights. They're manual. Well, they do work on automatic, but I'm talking about this is the manual switch for them. Now, push. This is a little different on the fog. Instead of a little button over here to push, you actually pull this out. This actually, I remember from the old F-350s, that's the way the F-350s worked. So apparently Lincoln has not changed to the little push button. Alright, that's how I open the trunk. You push that button, trunk pops up. Alright. By now, the sync dash, I really don't have to go through, it's all the same thing. Use these buttons for everything information, these buttons for everything entertainment and climate, but you can also manually do them. I'll press the navigation so you can see it's there. And then I'm gonna put it in reverse because I remembered. Backup camera, hey, two backup cameras, I remembered them both today. All right, now this has just the shift. It doesn't have a downhill assist control or an up down on the shifter. Does have here though, this is the auto park. So if you're gonna park this thing automatically, these are the buttons right there. In here, we have it's power, which you know can be a cigarette lighter or something you're plugging in. And then this is your rear shade. That's what that button's for. Now I'm gonna turn it to the back. Slowly, and then I'm gonna hit that button and see the rear shade come up. Cool. And I'll leave that up because that should be up anyways on sunny hot days. All right, and then here's your cup holder. Oh, yeah, it's a push to start and a smart key. I think this might be a remote start. Anyways, so for here, what we're going to do, again, same thing, you notice my foot's on the brake, right? So you shut it off, and then when you want to put it back on, now, if your foot is not on the brake, watch, won't start. Power comes on, but the car won't start. I put my foot on the brake, it starts. So you've got to have your foot on the brake to start it with push to start. Okay, so besides that, you got your leather, and it looks like they're cooled or heated. Looks like. And you got your grain. The reason why I'm saying that is up here, you got your plus or minus on the seats. So, actually, and then we have a, oh, I didn't do this yet. Here's your sink. Sorry, I'm skipping. Sink, there's your storage container. You do have power in here. Okay. I have another glove box here. Mirror on the visor. Storage. Storage. Sink for your garage openers. Lights. I think that's it. Well, push to talk, I didn't say that, but again, these are identical to the other Fords we've done today. So there's your volume, there's your seek for the radio, there's your push to talk. This, of course, is your cruise control. Oh, well, yeah, plus or minus is up here. Okay, found them. So this actually will, let's see, we'll put it in drive. So you watch over there, watch the number. So I'm doing the little paddle shift here. So if I was moving down the road, these little shifts will shift the gears. Right here. Cool. Now I think I got everything. There's the upgraded stereo marking. And I already showed you the back when I did the screen, so we don't need to go back there again, I guess. So I think we got it.
So this is a 2013 Lincoln MKS. Only feature I could think of it is missing is the sunroof. Outside of that, it pretty much had everything, including park assist, leather, navigation, looks like heated and cooled seats. Pretty sharp. So, side, which this will go for a front view. I haven't got a front view today, so I'm just gonna hold this here for a few minutes and try to make sure I get a nice front view. Battery's dying, so I think it's time to recharge the camera and go get some lunch and then come back and find something else good to shoot. Looking for.